is a contributing share, so no infrastructure schemes are taking up place. So this is the reason why I am strongly advocating for the National Judicial Infrastructure Corporation. I request once again, please consider this. At the same time, I am also requesting to expedite the filling of the vacancies also. Necessity is the mother of all inventions. The pandemic demanded us to transform the way we approach various issues. It has forced us to develop certain good practices which will support us in the days to come, although at a terrible cost. The Indian judiciary is one of the first institutions to shift to the online mode. This has opened a world of opportunities, and we have witnessed innumerable benefits arising out of it. For this, I must thank all my brothers and sister judges, particularly Brother Justice Kanvilkar, Chandrachud, and Nageshwar Rao, who are the heads of various committees in the Supreme Court relating to technology, as well as the Chief Justice and the concerned judges of the High Court. I am happy Justice Lalit working hard imparting NALSA schemes, and I wholeheartedly support his endeavors. We are fortunate to have enlightening company of our Brother Justice Kanvilkar. His commitment to the cause of access to justice is well known. Under his leadership, the Supreme Court Legal Service Committee has come to the rescue of many. I also thank to my two brother judges who have conducted insightful sessions, Justice Chandrachud and Justice Nageshwar Rao, earlier today on very relevant topics. Brother Chandrachud shared the session on technology and access to justice, a vision of the future, and as the chairperson of the e-committee, he has done a wonderful job. In fact, this morning we have released an application on various Indian languages, app which is useful to everyone. Brother Nageshwar Rao chosen a topic which urges introspection on our journey so far, 75 years of independence, constitutional perspective and vision. It is important to carry out such introspection regularly to chart our path ahead. It is the collective efforts of highly committed and dedicated officers and staff of the Registry of the Supreme Court who made it possible to organize an event of this magnitude. I convey my special thanks to each one of them for all the hard work they have been putting in the for making this event successful. The past 2 years have been very difficult for everyone. Many of our judges, judicial officers and staff have lost their lives. I can understand the amount of stress and suffering you must have faced in these tough times. However, these times have taught us to be ready for any future challenges, be it natural or otherwise. We must remember that whatever criticism or obstacles that we may encounter, our mission to render justice cannot stop. We have to march on in pursuing our duty to strengthen the judiciary and protect the rights of the citizenry. This sacred responsibility now rests upon your able shoulders. Thank you for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. On the momentous occasion of the 72nd Constitution Day, may I now request the Honorable President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind, sir, to deliver the valedictory address.